Deal.
Okay, we have our second playoff game of the week of the first round of the fifth season of the Ocho Trivia Challenge. Start off by introducing the teams. First off, we have the Liberators of Lexapro, the Needers of Antidepressants, today, Mentally Illest. To see first off, the Nerva of the team, ushering the new franchise into their hopeful golden age. First playoff appearance, their first season. Steven Constant takes. Takes? Takas? Takes. Okay. I'll keep his nickname from yesterday because it's just too apt. He is Tranquilo. When he speaks, you listen, because he always has something valuable to say. Brian Tomasco. And then finally, I'll call him the usher, not the singer, but the way he will quiet you down if he finds you distracting to their team, Andrew Rogalski. There you have Mentally Ill. On the other side, their music choice is very apt for what they're trying to do here. We have Lick My Qualls. First off, till he changes his profile picture, or I can find a better one, we have probably the 8th grade photo of Kyle Qualls, the glue guy, the second man of this team, always has something valuable to say, whether or not it's invaluable or just useless, and valuable in that way, he has something to say. Next, we have the assassin from Atlanta, Mass Sharon, always cruising, give his team the edge in any way that he can. And then we have, who's this guy? Noah Anderson. Bob mistakes him with Mars, I think just because they're both white, and not much else. There you have Lick My Qualls, the second game of the night. Mentally Illest versus Lick My Qualls. This is the 7 versus the 2 seed, the 2 seed versus the 7 seed. Mentally Illest coming in off a play-in victory versus Sandusky's Daycare. They are 5-9 for the season, but a very respectable 10.2 points per game. On the other side, we have the 2 seed, Lick My Qualls, tied Chicken Hawks, who just won in their previous game for the best record in the league, but Chicken Hawks won on a question percentage advantage. Lick My Qualls also coming in at 10.2 points per game. Mental Illest coming in with 69, nice, 0.2% on their own niche, which gives them a third place in the league because the first two teams are tied for first. I think that's like hive-minded someone else, but I don't know exactly. And then Lick My Qualls on the other side, I think second in question percentage with 58.7. Both teams have their strengths. Mental Illest, very, very solid on non-sports. Need to get some points on sports this or tonight just to stay even. And on the other side, a little bit of an inverse. Sports heavy, very solid. They need to get some points on non-sports. Hopefully, maybe they'll look for some phone of friends there. Last week, I guess yesterday, Mentally Illest won a play-in versus Sandusky's Daycare to make it here. And then last week, we had a rematch of this game, or we just had a match this game, where Lick My Qualls defeated Mentally Illest 13-9. It's a very close game between these two division rivals. First category we get into is NBA. Anyone like to double?
God damn.
No. Qualls, just say the line.
I know everything about the NBA. That being said, it feels early, and the NBA is quite, just as a category name, is quite broad, so I don't love it.
There's like a one-to-one correlation with us playing early and winning, but even being aware of that, we're still not going to double.
Every time we have this conversation, it all ends up being stupid easy, but yeah.
So excited for this game to take like 6 hours.
Yep.
Okay, so they're not doubling.
It's like six Patrick Cantlay's playing golf.
Mental Illest isn't doubling. Definitely. No one pointed that out, but I'm wearing a jacket because I always dress up for the occasion. Fuck all of you for not recognizing that. Mental Illest, your question. Identify the team with these leading scorers. You're not going to see the top scorer, but you'll see the rest. You'll see the position for the top scorer on this team. Fuck.
Huge.
You guys should have.
I animated this.
I told you to reanimate it, man.
Is it? Did you?
I totally would have gotten that too.
Okay. Yeah, that's easy too.
I'm gonna stop.
Would have given me the answer. That's a UConn guy, so we're gonna.
Ben McLemore.
Yeah, my first point in my feedback was please make sure to reanimate 1.1.
Okay, so I'll share the scoreboard. You guys can't see that I'm on the game, right?
Not currently.
Okay. Then I will make sure the next one is not that. God damn it. How did I animate? Okay, I animated the second one. I changed the second one, but not the first.
It's just like a rain delay. It's just, yeah.
Okay. The pitch clock is not in my favor.
Pitch calm error, yeah.
Yeah, this is a pitchcom error. Okay, we're back at it. This one's fine. I'll make up a new question. We'll be okay. Okay, your question, lick my qualls.
Please reveal.
Identify the team with these leading scorers.
Answer.
There you go. Give you a second, and we could start. Your timer is on.
Go ahead, qualls.
This would be the Timberwolves, right? Pekovic, I don't even know what other team he was on.
Wait, are these? Oh! I was thinking. I was like, are these guys even still in the league?
No,
I wasn't paying attention. Yes, this is definitely the Timberwolves.
Yeah. Okay. The Minnesota Timberwolves final.
That is correct. I didn't fuck this one up.
You should have doubled.
Okay. So 1 point there. You should have doubled. I'll never get over Qualls saying he knows everything about the NBA and still looking at Matt for confirmation.
Well, I just want to confirm. So it's called teamwork, Neil, not that you would
understand. You just said, I just want to confirm it when I said you look for confirmation. Thank you, Mr. Journalism Major. I appreciate that one. Okay. In honor of the quesarito, this is about discontinued foods because the quesarito will be discontinued. Get yours before April 19th. Would anyone like to double this?
No.
Okay, not doubling either side. Your question, Mental Illest. What fast food spot introduced the bacon and blue burger in 2010, keeping it until 2015, after a parade of reviews indicated it fell apart, causing a mess in the car?
Andrew, dude, this is right up your alley.
Why is this right up my alley? Because I eat fast food.
Ungodly amount of fast food.
Damn. Give me a second to think about this.
I have a guess here, if you don't, Andrew.
I do too.
Well, what were you going to say? Let's.
My instinct was Sonic.
I think that could probably be true. I don't know how much Sonic cares about shit falling apart in your car, though, because you know they just love chili dogs.
Yeah, but like it's also like you get served in your car. It's kind of part of it.
Now, do you remember something like that?
I don't know, man. We didn't have Sonic in 2010, 2015.
We did not. But yeah, Connecticut didn't.
Closing it on 5 seconds.
I'm okay with that, though. So we're going to go with that Sonic final answer.
It's incorrect.
I think this, what?
I was just going to say Checkers, maybe.
Hardee's. I was between Hardee's and Checkers.
Shit. Okay.
I was between like Checkers and like Burger King. Checkers?
Isn't Checkers like exclusively drive-thru? Or am I making that up?
I think you're right on that.
I think we're overthinking.
Okay.
But I'm fine with Checkers.
Five.
It's going to be some small regional chain.
All right. Yeah.
I'm pretty confident it's Hardee's or Checkers, damn it. Checkers, final answer.
Checkers, yeah.
Also incorrect. Okay. The opposite of a small regional chain. This is Wendy's.
Yeah.
Wendy's.
Okay.
Yeah, that's a small regional chain. I stand by that.
Okay.
I would
like thought it was an homage to the Checkers speech.
That's kind of what I was thinking, too.
Kind of the biggest the disadvantage of having Noah on your team is that you can't bring up Wendy's as an option.
No, you can't. Okay, look what calls your question.
I'm so restrained. It's
a
playoff
game. A longtime staple of this restaurant's menu, the Chicago-style hot dog was discontinued during the pandemic as the chain attempted to focus more on burgers.
Okay, right, now. Sorry, you go.
I was just gonna say it's gonna be like Wendy's size. It's not gonna be something
okay.
Small.
I was thinking because, like, hot dogs and burgers. Now I'm thinking Sonic for this one.
No, because Sonic very much still does hot dogs.
Okay,
but could they get rid of this one specific one?
Oh, dude, wasn't somebody?
What about a Shake Shack, or is that not like the same?
No, those would be Chicago style. I don't think.
I know, but they do sell hot dogs. I'm just trying to think of places that sell hot dogs.
One time staple. Could this be Hardee's? I've never been to Hardee's.
I don't think I have either. I'm fine with that.
It looks gross even in their commercials.
10 seconds.
Yeah, I'm fine with that or Sonic. Go with your gut, Noah.
Sonic's still doing hot dogs.
Yeah.
If it's between those two, let's go Hardee's.
Okay.
All right. Hardee's.
Final.
Not Hardee's. Other side.
Burger. Focus more on burgers. Does anybody know this off the bat?
No, I don't know this off the bat.
Yeah, no.
I was thinking maybe Shake Shack.
Shake Shack still has hot dogs, not Shake Shack.
Okay, what about Whataburger?
Honestly, I'm inclined to go with Burger King. I think they had a hot dog at one point.
Need an answer soon.
Yeah, let's go Burger King.
Burger King, final answer.
Both teams mentioned it. This is Shake Shack. Shake Shack.
Really?
Andrew.
Yes.
I literally had a hot dog from Shake Shack like a couple weeks ago.
But they have other styles of hot dogs. They don't have the Chicago style of hot dog, which is a staple.
I thought that was like a New York style chain.
I thought Shake Shack was a pretty good possibility, and I only dismissed it out of hand because I was scared.
The question was there, Andrew. I don't want to hear it through your body language. Okay. We move into the first round of niches. For Mentally Illest, The Lord of the Rings. The books. Which of the hobbits managed to kill an Oleg Hai, a specialized troll race bred by Sauron during the Battle of the Black Gate, being the very first to do so, the first hobbit to kill an Oleg Hai?
Okay, I know this. Let me just think through it. This is Mary. Final.
Incorrect.
Are you guys Lord of the Rings guys?
I mean, I know the main characters from. I've seen the movies.
I know the name of a character.
I know.
Could be an answer here.
Okay.
Oh, it's only round. Pippin's definitely a character. I think he's a hobbit.
Pippin is a hobbit, yes.
Okay.
I mean, it's a hobbit, right?
Like, yep.
It says in the question, which are the hobbits? Yeah.
Well, yeah, no. So, like, I'm saying, like, that's a possibility.
It's a viable answer. Yes, Noah.
Yeah. That's fine. Go with that.
You sure? You're positive?
Yeah.
Pippin, final answer.
That is correct. It was Mary's worst pass.
That's such an easy question, too.
Let's go.
They're so interchangeable.
On the niche deal there. Okay. So more question.
We have 3 points. Is that right?
Yeah, yes. But they've got a.
I have two. I have two, and you guys have one. Is that right?
Well, I'd say whoever talked me out of Shake Shack has minus one.
okay. We'll move on to everybody's favorite category: Ninja Sex Party. I love making questions for these.
And I love
your question, Qualls. Finish these lyrics. I'll give you. Until I count to five to read them. One, two, three, four, five.
Okay. No, I was listening to this song today, and I was like, I swear to God, if he makes me finish these lyrics, but I think I got it. And they're begging for one moment with your scrum. Final answer.
I'm almost positive that is incorrect, but this is just a temporary buzzer. We'll give the other side a chance because I don't remember the end.
We're probably not going to steal this, I guess.
What are we going to say here?
Can we say what he said, but scrub instead of scrum?
I think this one's Pippin too.
And they're begging for your crumbs or something. Like I don't.
And they're begging for your crumbs. Final answer.
Okay. Also incorrect. Sorry. Last word was schnub. You were looking for, and they're begging for one moment with your schnub.
I'm sorry, guys. That's
Qualls asked for lyrics. Everyone jot this down.
Every time you don't get a lyrics question, you get it wrong.
Complain.
Lyrics question that you got one.
Yep. I don't want to hear it anymore from him.
To be fair, I missed a made up word. So
you also listened to the song today. Literally today.
I did.
Literally today.
Noah, I would like the double, but they're pretty good at golf, and I feel like there's other categories where the knowledge is more.
If they're golf guys, let's hold off.
Yeah.
We can double something like NBA.
I feel like we should wait for like a history question. History or geography seems like we'll hold off.
Okay. Not doubling. Okay. So 2021 Ryder team or Ryder Cup profile. The question should be pretty self-explanatory, but if you need more specificity, I can see what I'll do. Okay. Identify the American golfer with these major finishes. So these are their best major finishes in their career, and based off the category title, they're going to be from the Ryder Cup team from the 2021.
Okay.
So it's those are their best finishes. Give you a second, and then I'm going to start the timer.
All right, no wins. Finished tied behind Tiger at the Masters. Is this Xander?
This might be Xander Schauffele. I'm going through the team in my head.
Yeah.
Tony Finau, but like I don't think he. I think it has a better chance of being Xander Schauffele.
10 seconds.
Okay. Let's go with that. We'll go Xander Schauffele. Final answer.
We worked it out together. That gets him on the board. This is Xander Schauffele.
Yeah. It's my Tiger 2019 Masters plaque is right there, and it says Xander came in second right on it. So,
Okay.
I knew that somebody else was also tied second at that one, who was on the team.
Your question, Lick My Qualls, is very similar. Just the other side. Identify the European golfer with these major finishes. I'll give you a second. Timer starts.
So, Noah, that's the PGA that Colin won, who came in second.
Yeah.
I think a year old. And he was around all the way back in 2010, so that rules out a fair few of their guys.
Shit, this is tough. This is really tough.
Yeah. Man, fuck. It's not – Haddon wouldn't have been tied third in 2010, right?
Seems pretty early.
Yeah.
It's not Frankie. It's a British guy, probably.
It's not Westwood.
It's not Rose.
10.
It could be Westwood. It's not Westwood.
10.
Shit.
Now.
I don't know.
Gonna need something soon.
This guy's known.
Westwood, final answer.
That is incorrect.
Damn.
30 seconds.
Being a European is tough.
Steven, where are your heads at here?
Let me think through it. This is the one that Morikawa won. He's been around for a while. No wins, though. There's somebody who's coming to my mind. But was Paul Kirsten on this team? Because that's the only person that I can think about who was around.
I, I think it's possible. Yeah. So,
need
Paul Casey final.
Paul Casey.
It seems let right. him. Oh, let him stew. That is Damn. Right. That is Shit. Right.
I was the U.S. Open scared
Paul Casey. So they sweep that category, gets them back in the game a little bit. Both teams have all their lifelines to use. We have 2010s pop songs. This is your music category. No. You'll be hearing something as a part of it, but would anyone like to double?
No.
No, I don't like this.
You think I hate America, Neil?
No, we're going to not double this.
Okay. I don't know. Do you hate America? There's a lot to hate.
Ooh.
Okay, not doubling, not doubling. Your question, okay. Mentally Illest. Zed paired up with what artist on this song?
Waiting for the time to pass you by. Hope the winds of change will change your mind.
Okay, so that song.
I see you, Noah.
Okay, do you guys know the title of the song so I don't say it out loud?
Yeah.
No, I don't.
I need the artist, by the way. I will specify that. I need the artist. That just...
I do know the song, Andrew. I can't think of the artist.
Okay, I have a guess. Six letters. Maybe at this point I just say it, but...
Yeah, I think you just go with it, honestly.
Halsey.
Who?
Halsey.
Oh.
I think that's right.
I think it is Halsey, personally. Do you guys want to punch that?
Go with it. Go
yeah,
with it.
You go with it.
All right, we're going to go with Halsey final.
Not Halsey.
Zara Larson?
No, Alessia Cara.
That,
oh, yes.
That's who I was thinking too, Qualls.
I know, it's 100%. I used to love this song. Yeah, it's 100%.
Yeah, I feel pretty good at that because the voice sounded either like her or like Halsey.
I feel you too. Judging me for my music taste, Peanut Gallery, but whatever. All right, Alessia.
This is not the song we're judging you for.
Yeah, man. What?
Alessia Cara final.
Between listening to about ear fetishes and feet fetishes, he gets this right because he was listening to Alessia Cara.
I was listening to that too, Neil, when I listened to your game from last week. That was cool.
Wait, what? What did I do last week?
The foot fetish category.
Oh, thank you. Yeah. We tried. We're trying to open up what's going on in this league. Okay. Your question, lick my calls. Martin Garrix paired up with what singer on this song? Fuck. Okay.
Here we go.
Switch this out at the last minute. We're not gonna do this again.
Just manually hit play on the icon.
Okay. I can do that. Oh, okay.
If I told you this was only gonna hurt, if I warned you that the fire's gonna burn.
Okay. All right, I know the name of the song. If I say it, would that help you guys remember? No.
Maybe.
I know the name too.
Okay, I don't. So maybe don't say it if you guys
don't. No, I don't think that's R. Larson. She's in a song similar to that one, though. I guess she's just in my head or something.
Is it Ellie Goulding?
Yes, it is.
Is it
featuring Ellie Goulding? Yes, 100%. Yes, send it.
Cool. Ellie Goulding, final answer.
Not Ellie Goulding.
Oh my god.
Damn, that was very confident.
Seemed right.
It is in the name of love. Yeah.
I don't know it.
This is a really tough fool here.
Camila Cabello? I don't know, dude.
No. Hold on. Give me a moment.
Need something soon.
Yeah. You know what? We're gonna go with Halsey for this final.
Okay. That is also incorrect. This is BB Rexha. Mm. BB Rexha.
That's a big surprise. Wow, I actually know who that is.
I was trying to get there. I was so close.
Okay. I really thought. Neil, what are your animations next game?
Hey, man, I did a lot of last minute switching, okay? Again, we also have a question in tow, so I have the question for that. I'll just still save it until the end so that there's no breaks. Okay, next round of quote niches. This is, I think you should leave quotes. So for mentally illest, your question for 2 points, this would square you back up at 4 for the moment. No, I eat blank all the time. What I don't like to make a habit of doing is eating blank. So I need both.
I eat paper all the time.
Paper all the time.
What I don't like to make a habit of doing is eating shit.
Yeah. Yeah. No, I eat paper all the time. Yeah. So we're going to go with that. Brian, you want a final?
Yeah, paper and then shit. Final.
Okay. I'm going to...
Okay, so
I'm going to buzz you for now, and we're going to go on the other side.
I've seen this sketch, and I agree that that's what they're talking about, but is it, you think it's paper and poop?
Yeah, you could just use a different word for shit.
Yeah. Okay.
Do you guys go with that?
Yeah, this is your game.
Paper and poop, final answer.
Okay, that is also incorrect. He says
hold on.
He says mud pie, not poop. You guys final answered that. I can't take other answer after the fact, fortunately. So I had to make sure because I got it off a site. I wasn't sure they were censoring shit or something because that's not something I could really check easily. Huh? No, like IMDb doesn't have quotes for this show. Like I couldn't find a single thing, like a database for it. So I had to like go through articles. It was tough, not gonna lie. Okay, so for Lick My Qualls, you guys get community. You can extend to a 4-point lead. In the series 3 finale, what is the name of the janitor that takes notice of Troy's handyman abilities?
You know, this isn't well before this. Not that it's important. It's just something to keep in mind when you're thinking about the character. Is it Gary? No, it's Jerry. I think it's Jerry.
Shit, man.
Is it Pippin?
But he's a plumber though. He's not a janitor.
No, I think it is both. I think he does both.
I think it's Jerry. I'm pretty sure it's Jerry. I have done nothing this game, and I apologize. But hopefully.
No, you're good. My only concern is that that's. Oh no, I'm thinking of a different janitor. Yeah, no, I'm good with that.
Okay, we're gonna go with Jerry. Final answer.
That is correct. Matt gets on the board.
I was thinking that Crazy Steve was named Jerry, but it's Crazy Steve.
He is a plumber. I think he was listed as both a janitor and a plumber. But
yeah, he is because he's a janitor, not a custodian.
Yeah. That they do make that.
That's
okay.
I think.
I'm getting big double vibes.
Yes, I think we should double this.
Okay.
We have 4 rounds left. 1 question still in tow, so we have 4 rounds and a question left.
We're probably going to get baseball, but we could. No, we aren't. We're going to get football. We could get baseball. So
we could.
I think let's just stick with this. You never know.
Yeah.
I double this and stuck with NFL.
Yeah.
Yeah. Send it.
You're doubling this?
Yeah. Yep.
Okay. It is 6-2 currently. Lead is in Lick My Qualls' favor. Mentally illest, if you're not doubling, you do have your phone a friend if you would like to use it. Here, your question. In 2019, Washington State played an instant classic, leading 49-17 well into the third quarter, only to give up 50 points as they lost 67-63 to this conference opponent.
Do we want to use our phone a friend here?
If nobody knows it,
yeah, who do we call?
Don't you have a college football guy?
Yeah, I could see. I could see if Adam knows.
Yeah, call. All right, okay. We're going to use our phone a friend.
Yep.
Okay, hold on a second. Using their phone a friend.
I'm going to throw my ear pods away because every single time I call somebody, it goes through these. So.
Yeah, I'm sure it's all fucky. I've had that issue. Ignore the timer on the top if it's still running by the time he picks up. I'll show you a timer on my screen. Remember, you'll have 30 seconds with him from the moment that you finish reading the question, and then 15 seconds after he hangs up.
Hey, so got a trivia question for you here, all right? I hope you do too. All right, in 2019, it's a college football instant classic question. In 2019, Washington State played an instant classic, leading 49-17 well into the third quarter, only to give up 50 points as they lost 67-63 to this conference opponent.
30 seconds.
Washington State is so UCLA. See.
You 10 seconds.
In conference. You got 5 seconds to give an answer.
Needs to hang up now. Gotta hang up.
Thank you.
Yeah, 15 to give an answer.
So he said USC is his guess.
Are they in the same conference?
Five yeah. seconds.
All right, USC final.
Incorrect.
This is UCLA.
That was my first thought, and I don't know why, but I mean,
it is. It's them. It's yeah.
Maybe that was my first thought, so I knew it somehow. But go for it.
Okay. University of California, Los Angeles. Final answer.
I don't like the way you pronounce that, but I'll accept it. That is correct. It is UCLA. So extended to 5 points. Use of a phone a friend there for mentally ill is still have their double. This one for 2 points to extend it to 7. Look, my Qualls, your question. Syracuse lost 76-61 in this conference game in 2016 as the teams combined for 47 points in the fourth quarter alone as they set the record for most points for a game completed in regulation.
I know the conference.
Yeah. I thought these would be big games. So I can't tell you Syracuse beat 20 or lost you in 2016.
I have an idea.
What's your idea in vague terms?
15 seconds under a table at a restaurant. Does that ring any bells?
No.
No.
Sounds like my wedding night.
that's pretty good reference there too.
Are you thinking Petrino, Noah?
No, I was thinking Patino.
But same school.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, fair.
That's not a bad guess.
That sounds good to me. I think, like, but based on who was there at the time.
That's the only reason I would guess that.
That's why I would guess it too, if I'm being
they're
honest.
They're in the same division, which I
10
guess
seconds.
It's more likely they played. All right, fine. Louisville final answer.
Incorrect.
That's a good guess.
Yeah.
ACC. I think it's a Pennsylvania school. They were suggesting Penn State, but I think it might be
Penn State is Big Ten. Pitt, maybe.
Pitt, yeah. Syracuse like does occasionally, like, prop up on your TV.
I kind of want to say Pitt. I don't know why.
Go for it.
Pitt final.
For 2 points, they get it right. This is Pittsburgh.
Oh, should we double that?
No.
Yeah,
crucial 2 points there. Keeps the game within reach for them because they still have their double.
Oh, bueno.
Go on to borders and coastlines. This is your geography question.
All right, I think we double this, guy.
This has to be the double. That's not for me yet.
Is it 7-6 now?
It is 7-4 right now.
We also have a hypothetical 1 point.
Yes, they do have 1 point remaining on a question.
Silver roll on that one.
Start of the game was rocky, so. Okay, so you guys are doubling this, mentally illest?
Yes,
correct.
Okay, so that'll be your lifeline. Mouse just keeps disappearing. Okay, that'll be your lifelines used after this round. Bone a friend still in tow for Lick My Qualls. Your question, mentally illest. After Alaska, what state shares the longest land border with Canada? I will tell you that we are excluding Michigan because it has like nautical borders that we don't want to worry about. This is solely what state shares the longest land border with Canada after Alaska, I guess Michigan.
Okay, so there are two that come to mind. They start with the same letter.
Yeah.
Right, same. That was the immediate thought that I had. Let's talk this out a little bit
between
now.
The two. I think I want to go with the one out west.
Yeah.
I agree.
The one with no professional sports teams?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That was funny.
The one that's noticeably more sad.
Yeah,
I mean it's pretty though.
It's super gorgeous.
That's the only thing.
I know that's and that's kind of. You see, here's the problem: is that they know what we're talking about at this point.
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
Which it is a straight line, but
I think it's Montana.
Yeah. All right. We'll go Montana. Final answer.
All right.
Incorrect. Not Montana.
Do I hear a crazy thought?
Yeah.
Could this be Maine?
Ooh.
My guess was Minnesota, but I could see Maine. Maybe.
My first thought was Montana. I'm a bit way off.
Those are like my two thoughts. Could it be North Dakota?
I was at Washington, maybe, because of all the islands. Well, like not the islands, but you know what I mean.
Sound.
Yeah, that's what I mean.
Need five, or you have 5 seconds. Sorry.
Let's just go know. Minnesota.
Let's go. Qualls, just say an answer. Go
Minnesota.
Incorrect.
Oh my God.
Noah had it. This is Maine.
I'm
Maine
sorry.
Maine comes in with a 611
I actually
miles.
Cannot believe
this
that's
close.
Right.
I think Minnesota and Montana are like 70 to 100 miles off in terms of power.
We'll look at a map because the next question there. Probably will be map based. But damn,
okay,
that's crazy.
Your question. So this is where the coastline comes into play. Like my Qualls, after Maine. Also excluding Florida because part of it is in the fucking Gulf of Mexico. So excluding Florida, what state shares or has the longest coastline along the Atlantic Ocean? After Maine, excluding Florida.
What would you call the body of water south of Connecticut?
I'm not going to answer that.
Oh, I'm asking my teammates here.
Okay.
I mean, It's the ocean. It's part of the ocean, I think.
Because, like, would you get Long Island on both sides? Because that's a lot of coastline.
Oh, shit. Yeah, I think that might be it. But
is that stupid?
Maybe.
Or me was thinking about North Carolina because of the Outer Banks.
Yeah, Outer Banks is pretty long. Barrier Islands run forever.
Massachusetts, maybe because of Cape Cod, but.
Yeah, maybe, but it's so small.
Yeah.
I'd go with North Carolina, or yeah. I have no idea, but I'm not going to say it. I mean, obviously, you know, the states, but just not to put thoughts in their head.
Yeah.
All right, North Carolina, final answer.
That is correct. North Carolina comes in second.
That last one fucked with our head so much.
Yeah, I know.
Okay.
Yeah, that one,
so
yeah, I knew that one.
1 point there. So 4 points. We have 5 points remaining in this game. Two timers. This is your MLB category of people that have made All-Star, you'll see in the question. MLB, no lifelines to be used for double. Your question, mentally illest. This Brewers catcher made 2 All-Star appearances during his time with the team, starting in 2014 and another as a reserve in 2016.
We have anything out there? That feels like a no.
Definitely a no for me. I mean,
I think former Brewers catchers.
Yeah, you got anything?
No. Just hold on. Still no, as an
gonna need something soon.
Rowdy Tellez, final answer.
Incorrect.
Sorry. Is this too early for Luke Roy?
Oh,
or
is
it Luke Roy?
It's Luke Roy, I think. Yeah. Qualls?
I don't know. So, but you guys sure sound confident.
Jonathan Lucroy, final answer.
Correct. It is Jonathan Lucroy. I was a little bit wary of with the, you know, Texas Rangers fandom.
No, you had it again, man. I was like, oh, I'm finally going to contribute to my team besides the community. You already had it.
Hey, man.
Okay.
It's tough. I know that feeling. Except I
believe that.
It's hard being such a balanced team like we are.
That does secure the game, I think, but play this one out. I'll do the NBA question if you guys
want. This is good. We're resting our stars. It's load management. It's a long playoffs.
Your question, Lick My Qualls. What corner infielder had his only two All-Star appearances in back-to-back years with the Reds, including a starting spot?
Is this back-to-back weeks of the Todd Father question?
Yeah, the Todd Father again.
Absolutely.
Tom's River's own the Todd Father, Todd Frazier, final answer.
Correct. It's Todd Frazier.
You just never really get rid of him, you know?
Yeah, same teams, too. I forgot. Oh my
shit, God. I did not know this was a question last week.
Probably it doesn't make any sense of knowing it, but it's just funny.
Okay. Computer parts, just a phone a friend in tow for Lick My Qualls. Your question, mentally ill is.
Can Brian triple this?
NVMe, SATA, and M.2 are all terms to describe what PC part?
Is there any way that we can like double or nothing this question with all of our points?
I don't think you guys can catch up. I'm a software engineer, not a hardware.
He does software, not hardware. But... you know, ironically, the one time we don't have a photo friend for Jared, this would have been a perfect Jared.
Yeah, it would have been really good for Jared.
This guy builds PCs all the time.
I kind of want to say GPU, but I don't think that's right.
I was thinking that too, but I have absolutely no grounds to say that. So
is GPU a graphics card?
Yeah.
Yeah, that was my thought. It could be fun.
Game's over. Yeah. Just chunk it. Go for it.
Yeah, so we're going to go with GPU final.
Correct. Not a GPU. Other side, 30 seconds.
We're going to CPU.
I'm thinking like keyboard or mouse.
It's not keyboard.
Floppy drive.
An M2 is a car.
M2 is a series of irons by TaylorMade.
All right, so what's iron on a computer?
What's the chemical compound? What's the chemical symbol for iron?
RAM, final answer. I don't know
what that key.
Also incorrect. I think you guys mentioned almost every PC part except this one. This is a hard drive or storage.
Hard drive.
Yeah, these are types of like SSDs or hard drives. Okay. Last question of the night. Core count, core clock, and thermal design power are all terms associated with what PC part? Good C is capitalized by mistake.
I don't know, like what gets hot in a computer?
A GPU. GPU, final answer.
Incorrect.
Is it this gross graphics?
Is that not what the graphics card was last time? It's the GPU?
I thought this would be like the chip, but I don't know.
The chip? what does that mean? What is the chip?
No, like Intel makes like X core chips.
Processing chip?
Sure.
Yeah, we're gonna go with a processing chip.
You know what? I'll take chip. I'll take chip as a right answer there. This is the CPU, which is the chip. Yep, you know.
Let's go.
It is the chip. Okay. So it ends 10-5. We didn't have to do the NBA question because of my
incompetence. Can we get it? Can we get it for fun?
Can we get the
sure. I can give it to you. I can try to let you have it for a point.
Just take our word. We do that one.
No, Neil. Okay. Give the point, not the question.
Oh man. Okay. They don't. They wanted to continue this. Okay. 10-6 is the final score of the game. That's how we'll end it. Mentally ill, would you guys like to say anything about season, outwent, anything in that regard?
Our goal was to make playoffs, so in that respect, we're just happy to be here. This was a brutally tough matchup for us. We knew that going in, but also it's frustrating to go out like on probably our worst game of the year.
I think this was an uncharacteristic one for us.
Yeah,
we did not show up. That was
especially coming off like playing really well last night. So that's frustrating. But like, I think the season as a whole is pretty good. Just got to learn to care about sports, which is tough.
Can't wait to see you guys again. Yep. just a tough night to, I guess, like niches, I think, just came into play. But again,
everyone else collectively fumbled at least one niche. So like,
yeah.
And those 4 points, but we would be tied. And those were easy questions, sure. But super gettable. Sure.
Look at my Qualls. Other side. Solid win. First round win.
Not
as guys are looking ahead
win.
Though.
We played like shit. I'll be honest. I had a bad game. I had a bad game.
Would you like to name names at all? Would you guys like to name names?
No, it's all three of us. It's all three of us. We did a bad job.
I think especially Matt.
If you want to name names, Matt, like we expect 4 points a game and we got 2. You know, that's not good.
Yeah, that was a bad game for me. Mentally, Illest are obviously really good, and they had a tough start. You know, getting used to the league to get here is very impressive, and obviously we got lucky.
They were a pippin away from a tie game.
Yeah.
And also like a mud pie, like that's
yeah.
We were fortunate too. I was so confident.
We were definitely lucky to win this one.
But you know, like we picked the wrong category to double. Golf as a sports other is obviously tough against them when they know best out of the sports other stuff. So, you know, it is what it is. But they played well, not played well, but they're a dangerous team, you know, and we're just glad to move on regardless of the stories.
Both sides have great respect for each other. You'll have to see that. I'll stop the recording.
We don't.